Hi guys. I'm Shay, and Henry's in front of me. That's Henry. He's gonna be upside down, I don't care. And we are heading to the pitch station. Go. And right now we're in
stuck
town.
Traffic.
Stuck in traffic.
Right,
and you've
got to hold his
gun
for like roughly.
So 1 minute. So you don't cry in front of me, so I went, no, because then I know you have a crime. And I was like, oh, yeah.
So I want to cry.
Why?
Because I don't want you to cry.
No, it's natural. I'm leaving you behind. You're not in great mood. I'm trying to make it to the last so we don't cry. Just look at Henry, don't make you laugh.
Pull the hat.
Not this again.
Oh. He's my friend Jerry. See? Jerry.
Basically, my coach arrives at 11,
and it will leave roughly 5 past 11.
Why are we doing it? That's the question.
Three limousines sweeping through the gates of this anonymous mansion house up on the hill.
Yeah.
August the 27th, 1965.
Screaming girls throwing themselves at the cars.
A secret meeting at Elvis's Bel Air Mansion.
Mind you, the 5 weeks has been epic.
Before we were us.
Before we were fab.
Loved it.
And now we're going to
nope, that last week just went too quick.
Marks this momentous meeting. But with Friday was fabulous.
Friday was fabulous.
On our way to meet the reason we exist.
Was it worth not seeing me every day from like early in the morning till afternoon?
I just didn't want to see you.
Yeah.
It's quite a story. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. Bobby Pryor is here once again.
I'm like, oh,
good. Great team you're working on. Holiday, says Johnny, the Pryor man. Not like those other slackers on Radio 2, sunning ourselves on the French Riviera.
Yeah,
we're
both wearing them today.
I'm not invited. I guess the bank's being closed means you have to find something else to do. Although I think the gold markets are probably still open. But are you real or just a recording?
What are you looking at,
Henry? Just a recording, Bobby.
He looked at me really funny.
Stop it. If you are recording and in the spirit of the Beatles, please can you play yourself backwards and we can see if there are any secret messages hidden in your show. There's a secret message hidden.
It's not one I can 54. Yeah.
Thank you, Ken. First of all, to the M42. Northbound, accident early and left debris on the carriageway. So between 1 and 2,
we've
got one lane closed again between Bromsgrove and the Red Turnoff. Now, just a quick update on Barnsley.
It arrives at 11.
Still close following this earlier building fire between Oaks Lane
it arrives at 11, don't it?
Lane. The M6 northbound, it's flooded between 1 and 2. So we've closed a lane between Rugby and the M69 Coventry turnoff. The latest on the M1 southbound, there's an accident between 6 and 5.
That's arrival time.
The Watford turn, the A405 and the A41 turn off. You've got one.
Yeah, there's the coach there.
The coach's just gone through.
Between three and
it will be there for 10 minutes and then it will go.
To Orpington, that's now all cleared out of the way. The A1M, though, southbound, we've got it still closed. It's Junction 6, that's the Wellington City turn off at the A1000. Now, they're taking traffic off and back on again via the roundabout now. It's a 4 mile southbound queue behind that. So that's not going to open anytime soon. And that queue is getting longer. It's just adding a mile every half an hour at the moment. The A26 at Kent at Merriworth. Thank you for your calls, by the way. It's all now clear between the 8228 turns. It was closed between 7 Mile Lane and Morning Road. That's now reopened.
The
A27 has reopened, but still with the lane closure between the A283, the short.
What number's that, Dad?
2025, the Lancing Manor.
Yeah, I can't see it.
The latest on the M4 eastbound at Maygold Services. Still one lane closed for repairs. And finally, the A31 eastbound. There was a the Emery Down turn off. That has now cleared out of the way and the queues have gone too. Thank you for updating.
Chance hasn't arrived yet.
Thank you, Bobby. Now we're back to the chart and the Beatles song number 33.
Yeah, receive it in the terminal or it hasn't arrived yet.
And I can't leave it was written like, in Scotland. Anyway, so, yeah. In his Scottish retreat. Secretary by Paul McCartney alone as a reaction apparently to racial tensions in America in 1968. We've got a recording here of the great Sir George Martin explaining how John and Paul approached their writing.
John didn't give a damn what anybody thought. Paul did. And that came out in their work, yeah, too, John because Paul like, would tend to write music that was acceptable.
Yeah,
John,
I'll check it daily.
He would write music that he
wrote once
was
a day,
right.
And then if obviously I've got
and people didn't like it, tough
on
them. So this is probably why Paul, in truth, has written much more commercial music than John. If you look at under Lennon McCartney, there's a great preponderance of Paul songs in that catalogue, which have achieved sales. So that if you were to divide them into Paul songs, Paul would be much wealthier than John. I think Paul always tended to think of his songs as being music to which he would put lyrics, whereas I think John tended to think of an idea and a lyric which had to have...
There's another one in there.
That's not
so we're cool. We got it. We did it. Yay. Well, at least we're not going to be late. It's bad that obviously we're here, but... It's good that you're not gonna end up home like super late. You see my logic?
Yeah. We just arrived at the coach station, my coach isn't here yet.
Yay, she gets to spend more time in dreary Southampton.
Oh no, it's taking it out. Oh, it's Ryan.
It's so drizzly and horrible.
I have to wear that one, that's the thing.
One coach though.
I know, but I have to wear it.
It's not the right one.
No, it's not that one.
Unless, of course, they change the number.
No, they won't change it, or else they would have contacted us.
No, I don't mean the number of the coach, the number of the coach. Like, if that swaps routes, that kind of thing.
Okay. I'm gonna go. I'm not gonna watch this crying. Bye, guys.